coffee and tea and the java and me. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup.
Hello everyone. Welcome to another session with Java with John. I'm John Rahans, the general manager here at Iron Oaks. And with me today is Ross Buckendall, our golf course superintendent. Ross, thanks for joining me.
Thank you for having me.
My pleasure. A couple weeks ago, I was out here playing golf. Course looked fantastic, and it still does. But something's changed. What's happening out here?
Yes, it has. We're starting to go through transition. We're starting to see that ryegrass and that Poa trivialis die off slowly with the heat and the Bermuda grass trying to come back. It's kind of a slower process. We're starting to get the heat that we need, but it's definitely changing. It's definitely changing. The nighttime temperatures are good, and you'll start to see some more brown spots. That's not necessarily a bad thing at this time of the year. It's just kind of an unnecessary evil and process that we have to go through to get to the Bermuda grass.
Right, and it sounds like the heat is making this transition, but also, when I'm playing, it looks like you're punching some holes out there.
Yes, we are punching a lot of holes. A lot of holes on the greens, fairways, roughs, you name it, we're punching holes as much as we can. The lack of rains, the need for pushing salts through the soil is very, very important. We do that with punching holes, trying to push that salt through that soil profile. And that also aids in transition as well, gives the avenue for the new Bermuda grass to grow. So it does numerous things by punching holes. It can be a nuisance, I understand that, and I'm not doing it to upset anybody, but it's kind of a necessary evil as well. So.
Right. Now, just out of curiosity, maybe for our residents' behalf, what is the difference in the amount of water gallons that you pump between winter and summer?
It's a lot. It's probably triple the amount of water. We like to, for a quick reference, we like to put the same amount of water in the month of April as we do total in January, February, and March. That's kind of when the time starts, and it's a little later this year with the temperatures being a little cooler, a little longer, so we're going to actually go into May here as well. So there'll be a lot of water flying over the next couple weeks, so the golf courses will play a little wetter, but again, we need to keep that plant wet and have that moisture available for it to be able to really flourish in June and July.
That's great. Just one more question for you. At the last board meeting, they approved new equipment for you and your team. What does that mean to you, and what are you getting?
Oh, that means the world to us. It makes things a lot easier to rely on. We know that we're going to have equipment that goes out there and does the job that it's supposed to. For example, we had two machines go down today, two machines that we are replacing. So to have that sense of certainty of those machines going out and not breaking down is very, very nice. We're getting some greens mowers. We are getting some turf sweepers, some more carts, and really that's about it. And a sprayer over for Ironwood as well. So we don't have to keep sharing that equipment and trying to spray on different days. Equipment for Ironwood and Oakwood both.
That's great. Well, good. Well, thank you very much for your time today. Ross, I want to thank you and your team for doing a fabulous job. Golf course is looking great. We're very proud of you and your team. Keep up
thank
the good
you.
Job.
Thank you.
Everybody, stay safe out there. We'll see you next time on Java with John.